my own, here we go.
Good evening. Tonight, I will be sharing with you one of my favorite stories. Lil Orange Cap. It begins on one dark, gloomy night.
That's the call of a blue-breasted woodpecker! Let me see if I can communicate! Oh my goodness! Oh my goodness! I'm Bear Grylls, and I'm gonna teach you what it takes to survive here in the forest of North Carolina. The first thing you want to do is to get to high ground. Shut up! Now the first thing is to climb that tree. I'm gonna show you how it's done.
This is really difficult!
Bear, I look down!
Who are you?
Bear!
Now once you've located the area and you see where you need to go, there's a river over there, that's where I need to go.
I've located the area! Now what we're first gonna do is find where north is. What you can do is get a stick. Okay, break it in half. Okay, now dig a hole. Just make sure it's really securely fastened in there. And get it down in there right good. All right? Now, the next thing you need to do, you stand back, you close your eyes, and you kick it.
That way's north.
Yes, you're correct. So we go that way for north, and that's where I'm heading. We'll be right back.
country.
Oh my gosh! What are you good for anyway? You're just a stupid Boy Scout.
I have lots to offer.
Of course.
Collecting! One of the hardest badges to get. Citizenship in the world. Showing our country proud. Swimming, one of the most hardest and most dedicated air badges out there. You had to swim for a mile to get this one. You just don't see you walking around, mister. This one is wilderness survival, which we can practice together. Together! And this one is emergency preparedness. That was a tough one because we had to sit in a classroom forever and ever and ever and ever and ever.
Okay. All right. Now, I'm going to go get firewood for our camp. You stay here and I'll be back.
Okay. Looks like I'll have to put up my hammock. A Boy Scout is always prepared.
Man, I've been running for a long time. Where exactly am I? Day 2, stranded in these godforsaken woods. You know, I'm running low on water, but I'm trying to keep my head straight. Day 8 in these terrible woods. Been hearing strange things at night. I really don't know what they are. Could be anything from a helpless skunk to a wolf or something. I don't know, bear. And turns out there's no pizza in this thing. What was that? It's day 11. I'm really freaked out here. I know there's something in the forest. Oh my gosh! You know what, Wolf? I'm sick of you! Sick of you coming here and haunting me! I want you to come out, meet me face to face, right now! I want you to fight me like whatever the heck you are!
Believe the day I've had, Grandma. It was insane. Oh! Why are your eyes so big?
Better to see you with, my dear.
What's up with your huge ears?
Better to hear you with.
And what's up with your teeth?
Better to eat you with, my dear.
No. What just happened?
Bear Grylls, I lost them.
Grandma, taters!
Thank you, Boy Scout, for your valiant efforts to save both me and my grandma.
You gonna let me get dressed?
Well, you see, young lad, it's the duty. A Boy Scout is physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight. If that wolf comes back, we're gonna have to train. What really saved you was this extra t-shirt. So let's get to training.
I need... Come and get me, you pathetic wolf!
I am trained in the way of the lightsaber now!
What a coincidence. So am I. I knew it.
Bear Grylls! Bear Grylls! Wake up! Not even the extra t-shirt can save this one.
I know. You're trying your hardest, and the hardest part is letting go of the nights we shared. Ocala is calling, and you know it's haunting, but compared to your eyes, nothing shines quite as bright. And when you look to the sky, it's not mine, but I want it so.
Now that was a Kasterparative production.